Hey guys, how's it going? Ricky here from Most Valuable Podcast, here to give you my 2015 NFL team preview for the, I want to say, defending Super Bowl champions. That's what I should be saying right now in this video. I should be saying defending Super Bowl champions, Marshawn Lynch. That's what I should be saying, because you guys should have ran the ball on the one. No, we've got to throw it with Russell Wilson. Okay. Soapbox over, but this is the Seattle Seahawks. I almost said Supersonics, because we all know we want them back. Preview, and I'm just going to say right now, spoiler alert, this is going to be a great season for the Seahawks. Kind of a quote, we already kind of went over what happened last season, got to the Super Bowl and lost. Can you make it three in a row? Can you get to the promised land 3 years in a row? Maybe. Maybe. I mean, the losses that you had this offseason, the biggest has to be Byron Maxwell. He went over to the Eagles, but guess what? He's not going to do anything, because from what I hear, Maxwell kind of said that he's going to guarantee that the Eagles make the playoffs. And usually when that happens, cough, cough, Vince Young and Dream Team, the Eagles don't do well. So you can just count Byron Maxwell and the Eagles out. Then you have guys like Zach Miller, no longer with the team. Tony Moyaki and O'Brien Schofield go over to the Falcons. You have James Carpenter going over to the Jets. You have Jaron Johnson going to the Redskins. And the last few names, you're probably like, Ricky, we don't care. Those are plug-and-play pieces. We've got Sherman. Bobby Wagner's locked up. Yeah, Cam Chancellor's like, you know what? I'm going to hold out to try to get some more money, but he'll be back when the games count. You got Russell Wilson locked up. And on top of that, you bring in Mr. Alexander and Will Blackman from Dallas and Jacksonville, respectively. You bring in your biggest offseason, I want to say free agent, but it was a trade, Jimmy Graham. He's going to be the number one receiver, duh, for the Seattle Supersonics. Russell Wilson has a guy that he can just throw it up to, and he'll catch the ball. It doesn't matter that you don't have anyone else. I mean, come on. The wide receivers for the Seahawks have really been lower tier guys. And just from watching last night, I was watching the first preseason game with the Seahawks and the Broncos. And the one thing I will say that is going to be the biggest thing throughout preseason, maybe the first few weeks of the season, is solidifying your offensive line. I mean, you had to give up Unger to the Saints in order to get Jimmy Graham. Just giving up that veteran presence in the core of your offensive line, that's the biggest weakness for this team. And if they can overcome that, it's going to be a great season in Seattle. Seahawks will have all the chances in the world to be the best team in the NFC and go on to the Super Bowl again. You guys pick up Frank Clark, defensive end out of Michigan, second round. Your third rounder, Tyler Lockett. Man, am I excited. I was not excited for this kid until seeing him in that week one preseason game, because boy, can that guy, he is going to be, if he doesn't play a lick of wide receiver for you guys, he is definitely going to be on that return team. Man, that 103-yard touchdown that he had to just, the kickoff return he had for the touchdown, man, was that fun to watch. So he's going to, even as a third rounder, I feel like he's going to find a way to help you guys this season. Really, to me, this is the same old song, different dance for the Seahawks. You're going to be just as successful. However, it's guys we lost, plug in with different players. Let's just keep on going. Pete Carroll football. And we're just going to get right into it. The most important part, the schedule, wins and losses. Here we go. Game one. I know I said earlier in the video, this is going to be a good season for the Seattle Seahawks. However, you're going to start out pretty bad. You're going to go into St. Louis. Upset alert. The greatest show on turf is going to beat you 0-1 to start the season. However, do not fret, because it's going to be a lot of wins between now and the end of the regular season. You're going to go into Lambeau. Toss up. I mean, the Green Bay Packers can beat you. However, Seattle with the win, 1-1. Then you play the Bears at home. I'm sorry, Chicago. I'm sorry, Jay Cutler. Not going to happen. Seattle with the win, 2-1. Then you play Detroit at home. That's a win. At Cincinnati, Andy Dalton, depending on what we see, I don't think it's going to happen. Seattle gets the win. Then you play Carolina at home. That's another win. The 49ers on the road. They're not going to be good this season. You beat them. At Dallas, this is going to be an interesting game because Dallas beat you at your place last year. However, good news for you, Dallas doesn't play good when they come home to Jerry World. I feel like the Seahawks can win that game. It'll be a toss-up. I'll put it as a coin flip game, but I'll give the Seahawks the win. So heading into your week 9 bye, you're 7-1. So that week 1 loss doesn't look bad anymore. Then you have Arizona at home. You'll beat them. That's a Sunday night game. Then you have the 49ers at home. You'll beat them. Like I said, they're not going to be good this season. Then you have the Steelers. This will be a tough game. And I know you're going to want to really beat them with the 12th man behind you, kind of to stick it to them for beating you in the Super Bowl. Or should I say, paying the refs more than you to have them beat you at Ford Field. Seahawks with the win on that Sunday afternoon in Seattle. Then you go on the road to play the Vikings. I'm a Vikings fan, but I can't lie about this one. I can't lie about this one. You're going to get the win. You'll beat us at home. Then you go on the road. You play Baltimore. You get the win. Then you beat Johnny Manziel in Cleveland at home. You get your revenge on the Rams. Then you're sitting there. You've only got one loss. You're 14-1. You go into Arizona. Carson Palmer might not be playing this game, but I feel like Arizona as a team, I feel like you'll split. So you may lose the first one, but I'm going to give you guys your home game, and I will give Arizona their home game. You'll finish. You only have two losses in the division, so you'll be 4-2 in the division, 14-2 overall. And if I'm not mistaken, I have you guys as the best team in the NFC going into the playoffs. And the only reason why I have you as the best team is because you beat the Green Bay Packers. So that week 2 game is going to be the most important, because with that win, you guys will have just enough to go ahead of the Packers in the standings, have home field throughout, and you'll get a bye. There's no way I see the Seahawks not getting a first round bye. They're either going to be 1 or 2 in the NFC this year. Russell Wilson's back with a new contract. Bobby Wagner's back. Like I said, Cam Chancellor, I didn't mention Earl Thomas. He's out, but he's going to be back this season after he heals from his injury. Cam Chancellor's not going to hold out when we get to actual regular season games. So it's going to be a good season for the Seattle Seahawks. Let me know, Seahawk fans, down below, what your expectations are for the season. Can you get back to the Super Bowl? Are you going to make it 3 years in a row? Can you win this one to go 2-1 in the last 3 years of the Super Bowl? Like I said, let me know down below. You can click right up here to check out the Onside Kicks NFC West podcast preview. You can follow me on Twitter at Ricky Widmer. Most Valuable Podcast is Most Valuable Pod. Thank you guys for checking this video out. And as always, have a good day, everybody. Hey guys, like the video? Then hit that subscribe button. But if you liked it even more, you should check out our Patreon page. We have a lot of different rewards and goals for those of you who would love to support us. So make sure to click that link down in the description to check out those pretty kick-ass rewards.